Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and welcome to my Doctor Who Season 26 Blu-ray box set unboxing. I apologise that this has been a little bit late. The reason for that is because I wanted to kind of save this video for a special occasion, and more on that in a little bit. But here we are, we have this wonderful box, and the reason I have not actually cut the sellotape and stuff on it yet is because I'm going to use a knife, and if I'm going to mess this up, I want to at least film it. The collector's value. This is the most graceful unboxing I've ever done. Blimey, this box is tearing here, there, and everywhere. Here we go. There we are. Aha! As usual, I've ordered this from HMV. The next box set that's coming out, season 14, I didn't order from HMV because it was a whole £10 more expensive. So, yeah, but anyway. So, Doctor Who, The Collection, season 26, with Sylvester McCoy on the front cover. I am really glad that they gave him the darker jacket to reflect the darker outfit he wore in the last season. Anthony Ainley at the front, the Destroyer. What's his face? I can't remember what he's from. Morgana from Battlefield, the knights there, awesome stuff. So before we take a look at the rest of the packaging, let's get this thing open slightly more delicately than planned. There we go. Got the slight tear there, which I can take advantage of. I'm really trying to appease the ASMR demographic here. I hope it's working. And here we are. Doctor Who The Collection Season 26. Build your own Doctor Who archive with the Ultimate Collector's Set. The stories, Battlefield, Ghostlight, The Curse of Fenric, Survival. All 14 episodes newly restored for Blu-ray and packed with brand new extra material. So there's only 14 episodes on this. There's only 4 stories. It's kind of akin to a Trial of a Time Lord box set. But much like that box set, there is a hell of a lot of special features. Many of them exclusive to this Blu-ray. Some of them from the previous DVD releases. I'll take a look at the booklet inside because there's a special feature on the Survival DVD talking about the unproduced Season 26. Seven. That was really interesting. I'd love to rewatch it. Let's see if it's inside. But first, what have we got? Rare extended VHS versions of Battlefield and the Curse of Fenric, Ghostlight extended work print, Buried Treasure, 30 Years of Fenric, and 1 hour documentary about the making of that story. In conversation, Matthew Sweet chats to Sophie Aldred. Showman, The Life of John Nathan Turner. This is apparently one of the big reasons to get this box set if you're a completionist. Just a big feature-length documentary looking at Doctor Who's longest-serving producer. Not just producer, he'd been working on the show, I think, as a floor assistant during the Patrick Troughton era. He was one of the few people when he was on set with Tom Baker who actually had been on that show for longer than Tom Baker. Behind the Sofa, new episodes with Sylvester McCoy and Sophie Aldred, companions Janet Fielding, Sarah Sutton and Annette Wills, and 13th Doctor writers Pete McTigg and Joy Wilkinson. Becoming the Destroyer, learn how the cast and crew brought this fearsome monster to life, only for it to not do a single thing in the episode. Ah, the Destroyer, it really was the Rachnos of its time. And the Blu-ray trailer, The Promise, Ace Returns, that's the one that was launched at the announcement of the Season 26 box set, where Sophie Aldred returns as Ace for the Charitable Earth Foundation little mini-episode, mini-trailer. That was a really cool thing, and I'm so glad they did that. Okay, this irks me. If you've been watching these box sets since the beginning, you'll know that I had an issue with Anthony Ainley not getting a credit in this thing, but Nicholas Courtney did. Even though Anthony Ainley and Nicholas Courtney are both in this collection, Anthony Ainley's in Survival, Nicholas Courtney is in Battlefield, neither of them are here now. What is happening? BBC Worldwide, I know you watch my videos, it's why you hate me so much. Are you trying to antagonize me? So let's get this sleeve off here, let's see what the back is. Off the top of my head, I don't really recognise... Oh no, it's not from a scene, it is from the opening title sequence. It's the revolving TARDIS that's in the opening when the rocks are going everywhere and it's in that weird blue bubble. So let's get this thing open, and we have a gorgeous illustration from The Curse of Fenric. We open that up with the Velcro. We have a compilation of moments from Survival. That looks awesome. That makes that battle on the cheetah planet that's been destroyed seem even more epic than it was in the episode. And it's kind of weird. I can't quite remember off the top of my head, but the TARDIS, the Doctor's TARDIS at least, was hardly seen in this series. I think it only maybe appeared in like one or two episodes of the whole run, because the set was basically falling apart. It was like in a state of massive disrepair, so when it did turn up, it was massively underlit and they hardly used it. So I'm kind of surprised that they actually had any reference material for this inside art of the box sets. That's even if they did have it in this season. I can't quite remember off the top of my head. Okay, so let's have a look at the booklet as well. Awesome, continuing the tradition with the photo of the lead actor at the back. Cool behind the scenes picture from The Curse of Fenric. Ending on a high, welcome to season 26. At the start of 1989, Doctor Who was well and truly back in business. 2 years into Sylvester McCoy's run as the Doctor, script editor Andrew Cartmell and his team of writers had taken their programme in a bold new direction, telling ambitious, complex, relevant stories with arguably the most successful Doctor companion pairing in years. Yeah, it's not just like trying to look back with rose-tinted glasses. I did a Twitter poll like a week or two ago, at least at the time of recording this video, and the quality like jump up is notable, with people saying that this is the best Sylvester McCoy season, with season 24 not only being the weakest but the weakest by far. The McCoy era just got better as it went along. I'm kind of surprised that they released season 26 first. I would have maybe gone with season 25 or just season 24, because there is only the three seasons, so you might as well just do them in order. But season 26, in terms of quality, I'm not complaining that this thing got a release. Firstly, we've got Battlefield, which is, in my opinion, the weakest of the four stories. It's still decent, and Nicholas Courtney is just great to see him. He always brings his A-game, and it was great that the Brigadier did get one last story in the classic series. But I could take it or leave it. It's alright. What else have we got? So here we've got Ghostlight, which many consider to be Ace's like definitive story. We have The Curse of Fenric, which I think might actually be the best of this season, in my opinion. I think the last three, it is a crapshoot. Like, ask me any day of the week which is the best one. I could tell you a different one every day. But yeah, The Curse of Fenric's terrific. And lastly, Survival, which was a terrific way to end the classic series. It is just a genuinely great story as well. I did peek on ahead, and I noticed that documentary about the proposed season 27 is actually on the bonus disc. It's on the same disc as the Showman documentary and the Sophie Aldred in Conversation one. So a look at what might have happened had Doctor Who continued to 1990. The documentary is called Endgame. That was really interesting, really informative. So yeah, I would recommend checking that out if you have missed that from the DVD run. All right, Winnie. Black Cat. How appropriate for this box set of Survival. Last but not least, I'll look at the discs as well. Let's wrap this thing up. So, what we have here. Season 26, disc 1, Battlefield. Great, now the cats are away. I started this when they were asleep, and now they've decided to wake up and wander around the house. So, disc 1, Battlefield. Disc 2, Battlefield. It's only a 3-episode story, isn't it? Next up, disc 3, Ghostlight. Disc 4, The Curse of Fenric. Why does Battlefield get two discs? Disc 4, Curse of Fenric. Disc 5, also The Curse of Fenric. Disc 6, Survival. Disc 7, bonus disc. And there we go, Sylvester McCoy's face. I'm surprised he's not winking. And just for completion's sake, let's take a look at how the collection is coming along. So there's season 26, season 23, season 19, season 18, season 12, and season 10. It's quite a handsome collection. Let's see if I can organise this a bit more, in a bit more of an aesthetically pleasing way. So there we go, this is the collection so far. Blimey, it's growing quite quickly. I mean, it didn't feel like that long ago since I started doing these unboxing videos, and I'm not normally a collection person. Like, I don't actually own that many DVDs, the Two Entertain DVDs, and I've not actually bought one for years, mainly like because of like in case they did start doing collections like this. And you know, since I made the jump up to Blu-ray a few years ago, it's kind of what I've been buying now instead of DVDs. But yeah, this is an awesome looking collection. I'm looking forward to season 14 when that comes out in a few months' time. Now, I know that many of you are probably expecting some crazy stuff to happen, and for this case, I've not allowed that to happen. I have a very tight schedule. In fact, the reason that I'm kind of hurrying my way through this is because I have an appointment to keep. I have somewhere to be right now, but first, I've got to take something very important with me. Firstly, this. And most importantly, this thing. Let's go exploring. Okay, so let me tell you how the past day went down. So, as soon as I did my unboxing, I hopped into my car and I headed out into the Manchester city centre. It was a completely uneventful drive, nothing to really report on or talk about.
Into the unknown! Into the unknown! Into the unknown!
Then I parked up and I made my way to a place called Fab Cafe, where Sophie Aldred herself was doing a Q&A event. She was doing a panel, she was doing a signing because she has her new book, At Childhood's End, which is a Doctor Who novel which sees the return of Ace meeting the 13th Doctor 30 years after the TV story's survival. And it was a really cool panel. The moderators were fun. Sophie Aldred was a bloody rock star there. She was really fun interacting with the crowd, having a really good time. Seemed like she was genuinely enjoying talking about the show. And also, of course, she's promoting her book, and she had a lot to talk about the passion that she had for the story and the character and the book itself. And one of the best things she did during the panel was actually do a reading of the scene of the end of the chapter where Ace finally does meet the 13th Doctor, and she was giving them voices as well. She does a terrific Jodie Whittaker impression, that Huddersfield accent. She also does a really good Tozzin Cole, Mandip Gill impression. You can tell that she's been doing Big Finish stuff for around 20, just over 20 years, because her voice acting, her vocal capabilities are really top notch.
As she stepped through into the space beyond... Oh, no, I found a typo. How annoying. Oh, that's annoying. Three startled faces turned to look at her. Two of them, a man and a woman, appeared to be in their late teens, while the third was an older, grey-haired man in a smart leather jacket. But it was what stood beside them that took Dorothy's full attention and almost took her breath away. The TARDIS... unashamedly incongruous, and possibly the most beautiful thing Dorothy had ever seen. The seconds passed, and as the breath returned to her body, she turned to the boy. Where is he? The boy stared at her in bemusement. Where's who? Are you one of the crew here? The girl asked. Impatient now, Dorothy took a step towards the TARDIS, bellowing through the doors. Oi, Professor, come on out! The older man stepped across the doors, blocking her. Believe me, love, there's no one called the professor in there. They know me as the doctor. Dorothy turned at the sound of the warm northern tones to see a tall, slim, blonde woman in a long grey coat standing inside the door. Her grin was as bright as the stripes of colour across her top, and it was a smile of recognition. The doctor's grin grew wider. It's good to see you again, Ace. Dorothy felt the warm rush of surrender. Blimey, Professor, it really is you.
The panel itself was also really interesting, really informative. There was a really great story that she told where she met Russell T Davies for the first time last summer in Edinburgh when he was being presented with like a Lifetime Achievement Award, or maybe it was the year before, and it was the first time that they'd actually met up with each other, even though Russell T Davies did incorporate that moment at the end of Sarah Jane Adventures episode talking about what happened to Ace, where she wound up organising a charity, A Charitable Earth, which is what we've seen in At Childhood's End and also in other pieces of media. And Sophie Aldridge said that there were indeed plans to bring back Ace, that maybe every season of the Sarah Jane Adventures they would bring back a new old classic companion after Katie Manning returned as Jo Grant in the season before, and that a sports car would arrive on Bannerman Road, and then someone in a really fancy expensive suit would step out of the car, knock on the road at 13 Bannerman and knock on the door at 13 Bannerman Road, and Sarah Jane would open the door and Ace would be there. And that was all they had written for the story, but that seems like one hell of an entrance. And the best part about going to any sort of fan event is the swag that you can get. So I got this poster, a poster which is essentially the cover of At Childhood's End. Sophie Aldred, Past or Future, Which Path Do You Choose? And along with my entry ticket, I got a copy of At Childhood's End, written by Sophie Aldred. There's the awesome back cover with Ace there. And best of all, it didn't come pre-signed. We had to get in a queue and speak to Sophie Aldred afterwards. And she signed my copy to William, love Sophie Aldred, and there's a kiss there. So I actually have already listened to the book. I've not read it, I listened to it because it was on Audible. So I've listened to it. If you want me to review the story, then leave a comment in the comment section below. If you want me to review, I don't know how I'd do it because it's not really a visual medium. But if you've got any suggestions, if you would like me to review At Childhood's End, like I'm sure you're aware, there's not going to be much Doctor Who this year to talk about, at least on TV. So if you want me to review that, please let me know. However, I also want to thank Jamie, the time agent himself. He was actually at the event. It was a complete coincidence. I had no idea he'd be there. Thankfully, he was there because he was able to help me film the moment where she signed my Season 26 Blu-ray Collection box set. She says yes to William, love Sophie Aldred with a kiss there, on top of Sylvester McCoy's head. This is what I wanted from the event. If it would have been a choice between signing the book or signing the box set, it may sound a bit selfish, but I would have chosen the box set. But it was great to get the book as well. I enjoyed listening to the book. And this is like the second time I've actually got a main Doctor Who cast member to sign anything years ago. I'm a very, very first ever convention. I met Colin Baker and he signed my DVD of Mind Warp because that was like my favourite story of the Colin Baker era. Now I need to find him again so he can sign my Season 23 collection. So hopefully that'll be on the cards in the near future. Who knows what will happen out of WarpCon this year if I choose to attend. But yeah, getting this signed was the main reason for going. But I'm also thankful that it was a really good panel. It was a really entertaining Q&A. Sophie Aldred was terrific. It was great to see Jamie there as well. And once again, thank you to Jamie for filming the moments where she did end up signing the box set. So that kind of concludes this box set, this unboxing video. I know you're expecting things to go tits up or something to go incredibly wrong. That, of course, was the plan. I had a proper plan for this unboxing video. However, once I realised that Sophie Aldred would be coming to Manchester, to my home city, and I'd be able to get to sign this, potentially, I knew this is what the video had to be about. It's also the reason why this video is a couple of weeks later than I wanted it to be, because Sophie Aldred was meant to be coming to Manchester 2 weeks prior, but because of bad weather, because of storms, we've had really bad weather recently in the UK, really bad flooding, really bad rain and winds, she actually could not get the train up from London or wherever she was to Manchester. She was at a convention the day before and then arranged to do this panel the day after, and she just could not make the travel arrangements because the weather was so bad. So they had to postpone the event by about 2 or 3 weeks, which is why this video ultimately ended up getting delayed. But hopefully it was worth it. Hope you enjoyed the unboxing. I'm really looking forward to watching the documentaries and revisiting some of the stories on here, particularly Survival, because that's one hell of an episode. So, thank you so much for watching this. Be sure to appease the YouTube algorithm by liking this video, leaving a comment, any comment in the comment section below. Let me know if you do want me to review At Childhood's End. Like I said, I've listened to the audiobook, so I could even maybe incorporate some of that into the review. Yes, Sophie Aldred does do voices for all the characters, including Bradley Walsh, including Sylvester McCoy. She does great impressions of everyone except Sylvester McCoy. One story she told at the panel, John Coleshaw, who is a very, for those of you who don't know, he's a well-known impressionist. I believe he's currently voicing the Brigadier and the Third Doctor in the Big Finish Adventures. He was also a Tom Baker impersonator before Tom Baker officially started doing audio productions. Thanks so much for watching this video. Like I said, let's appease that algorithm. Also share this video around as well. And I'll see you folks next time.